Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video today, I'm going to give you guys a series of useful tips and hacks on how to learn English fast and efficiently. I've been learning languages for several years now, and I personally found these tips to be the most useful. And speaking of languages, if you haven't already done so, go ahead and check out this video here where I speak in 7 different languages. So without any further ado, let's get into it. Tip number 1, find a reason to improve or learn English. Now, what I mean by reason is to simply ask yourself the big why question. Why should I improve my English? It sounds very simple, but most people tend to ask a lot of how and what questions before they start something like improving a language or even starting a business. They feel like these questions are the most important questions, and they are till a certain extent, but they're not the first question to ask. To put it in perspective, the what question relates to the materials and resources that you'll use, and the how question is the plan of action that you'll take in order to achieve your goal. However, to be successful, ask yourself, why should I learn or improve my English? Let me give you an example. In both cases, my why for learning German and Japanese was my passion for the country's culture, so that learning languages was a way to connect with the natives and discover the culture in a way that's not really possible if you're trying to communicate in English. When I wanted to learn German specifically, I didn't really care about the how and the what, because I knew I could do some kind of intensive course if I wanted to. But my why was way more important to me, because it gave me that energy and motivation to learn the language. And looking back at it now, if I were forced to learn German at school, I would have never learned it as fast as I did years ago when I had that burning desire to learn the language. If you concentrate way too much on the hows and the whats, you'll end up learning a bunch of grammar, a bunch of vocabulary that you'll unlikely be able to apply in real life. So find your why. And by the way, you guys, I've created a super useful English goals document that you can download right now to help you with setting your English goals. The download link is in the description box below, so go ahead and check it out. Number 2, decide what you want to do in English and when you want to do it. The how. This is probably the easiest part. All you have to do is set a goal and a deadline and stick to it. Think about what exactly you want to achieve. For example, in 6 months' time, I want to be able to get a 6.5 band on IELTS in order to get into UCL for my master's, because it's part of my conditional offer. And once you do that, you will have a clear goal in mind, and then you'll be able to work towards that goal every single day. And this brings us to the next tip, the what's. Remember, the what is simply the study material that you will use in order to achieve your goal. Number 3, as much as you really want to study English independently and do your own thing, online courses are an extremely powerful tool that can help you bump your English to the next level. I just want to stress here that this is not a standalone solution. You should do this alongside everything else that I talk about in this video today. An online course will give you a solid structure, and you'll be able to really work on your weaknesses. It will also make you accountable to someone if, say, you get an online tutor or you simply pay for it. You will get this sense of obligation to get your money's worth if you pay for something.
Yeah, I like money though.
And hey, that's why most people, when they want to lose weight, they get a personal trainer or a nutritionist. Also, when you're busy with life and have a hectic schedule, it's really hard sometimes to motivate yourself to study or even think about what to study on a given day. With an online course, not only is it easily accessible and you don't need to physically really go anywhere specific, you also don't have much thought given to structuring your study sessions. Now, I took the liberty of doing some online research, especially for you guys, and found the 8 best online English classes of 2020. I'll link of that in the description box below. Tip number four, striving for perfection and the fear of failing. These serve as a huge barrier to your progress. Yes, grammar and syntax are important parts of verbal and written communication. It's what keeps you from sounding like Borat.
Is a VCR recorded?
But if you're always too shy because you want to sound perfect and have a constant fear of failing, then you won't really get far. In fact, it won't get you anywhere. I understand that we were always taught that making mistakes is bad, especially at school, and the fear of failing is an innate human condition. But you need to understand that failure is a good thing. It's actually a blessing in disguise. The more mistakes you make, the more improvements you will make. So how do you get over shyness? Well, for starters, if you're constantly scared of making mistakes, you can make a habit of using words that you already know to explain a difficult concept or idea. For example, when I recently spoke to an Italian colleague of mine, I didn't know how to translate the word litigation paralegal to her. So I ended up telling her in sheer detail the kind of work that I do, and at the end, I came up with an Italian equivalent, assistente d'avvocato. And what I noticed from this experience and talking to native speakers of several languages in general is that native speakers are flattered when you try to speak their language, no matter how many mistakes you're making. So there's absolutely no need to be shy. Believe me, they're most likely impressed that you're straining words into sentences. Bottom line here, don't be shy and don't worry at all about making mistakes when you speak. In real life, nobody judges you for making grammatical mistakes and stumbling on your words.
I'm quietly judging you.
Remember this, before you learn how to run, you need to learn how to walk, right? And stumbling and falling is all part of the process. So practice makes perfect, which brings us to tip number five. Practice, practice, practice. In my humble opinion, practicing to speak English is way more important than spending hours doing grammar exercises. And you're probably saying, oh Dasha, I have no one to practice English with. What am I gonna do? And to that I say, good point. That's actually a really good point. Well, for starters, just talk to yourself. And I don't mean in the creepy way.
Well, Isma just tossed me this knife and asked me to, you know, take that map. And then this guy popped up.
Talking to yourself is a really great opportunity to express yourself when no one's watching, no one's judging you, and you can completely relax. Plus, by putting words into practice, you'll be able to make associations with those words by having already used them in a particular context that you just basically made up. There's a lot of ways that you can do this. For example, if you talk to yourself when you're by yourself at home or revising at a quiet place or in front of a mirror. Heck, I even sometimes talk to myself in the shower. And one of the most important things you should remember is that it's totally okay to make mistakes and you shouldn't just stop because you're making mistakes when you speak. Don't let that put you off. So, what can I talk about, you say? Well, to give you a few ideas, you could, for example, talk about something very simple like how did your day go, what did you do, a recent experience, a place that you visited, something you read, maybe the news. You will see that the more you advance at a language, the more complex these soliloquies will get. I personally find it quite useful to read news articles and then summarize them orally. I think it's just a great way to test your understanding of what you've just read in a foreign language. And also at the same time, it encourages you to learn new vocabulary because you can just basically Google it if you don't know a certain word. And another great idea for a self-conversation is that you can just pretend to be giving an interview about an achievement. The best part about talking to yourself is that you can do this no matter how novice or how advanced you are in English. It's also really important to speak out loud in a clear voice instead of having internal conversations in your head or muttering under your breath. That way, you'll be able to not only A, practice your pronunciation,
I would like to buy a hamburger,
but B, It will help you remember words and expressions. And of course, there are a ton of online resources like podcasts and apps that you can use to practice speaking English and any other weakness that you may have. They're usually not free, which kind of sucks, but it's worth the money. So for example, you can use Skype tutors, Preply, Verbling, which are really great resources, and I actually went ahead and put the links to them down below in the description box. Tip number 6, concentrate on audio and video content. Yes, I'm telling you to watch lots and lots of movies, series, YouTube, anime, you name it, go crazy. Lots of scientific studies have actually shown that when you stimulate your auditory and visual senses, you pick up information way quicker than if you were to simply read it on a piece of paper, for example. Also, when you're watching a movie, you get to hear the words used in a specific context. That way, you'll be able to better understand when you can use certain words or expressions. You will also be able to pick up everyday idioms and expressions that native speakers use, which is way better than listening to a short, random conversation that's pre-recorded. There are two things that you can do in order to maximize learning English through audio and video content. Number one, if you're watching a movie, just pause it if possible, so not like on a movie night with your friends or something like that, and repeat a word or an expression that you maybe heard for the first time. And if you don't understand what it means from the context, then just Google it. Which brings me to number two. Write it down in a notebook, and then you'll always be able to look back at that expression, learn it, use it, easy. Number 7, read more to expand your vocabulary. You're probably rolling your eyes, and I know this sounds much more tedious and less fun than watching movies all day, but believe me when I say that this actually works. Now, I wouldn't say that you should spend a disproportionately larger amount of time reading than listening to English. I think that there should be a balance. But if you want to broaden your vocabulary, then reading is your go-to. This, of course, depends on your level of English and what kind of material you're able to read. For example, right now, I'm not at a stage where I can read long news articles in Russian, but I am able to read posts on Instagram and short news pieces. So here's what I'm gonna ask you to do. From tomorrow onwards, make this your habit. Read a couple of news articles every single morning when you're having, say, your cup of tea or coffee. They don't have to be long articles. For example, The Economist does this Express News app that you could read. And if you find a word that you don't know, you can just copy-paste it into your notes on your phone, write it down in your notebook, and then find the meaning of it and learn it. If you're more advanced and love reading, then you can just get a Kindle or download the app on your phone and just read books. The cool thing with a Kindle is that if you don't know a word, you can just tap on it and its definition will just pop up on your screen. And I find that very useful. My biggest tip for you guys here is to read something that genuinely interests you, because you shouldn't force yourself to read stuff that you find boring or that you're not interested in. Number 8, stop translating word for word. Guilty as charged, I do it myself, and it's a terrible habit. You need to switch off your native language in your head. Just forget about it. It's not there anymore. You have to own the words that you already know in English and own that English vocabulary that's just sitting there buried in your subconscious. Tip, if you're talking to a native or somebody that already knows English very well, try to mimic them. Mimic their pronunciation and their tone of voice. Fun fact, you'll probably do this automatically, but do try to do it consciously. This will most definitely improve your pronunciation and speaking skills. Number 9, don't give up. Commitment and perseverance are the key to success. You need to commit to the goals that you've set and always remind yourself of your why. Why do I need to improve my English? And that's because motivation and commitment are two completely different things. Let me give you a real-life example. I have a passion for Olympic weightlifting and I train 5 times a week. Now, I might not always be motivated to train and go to the gym every day and give my 100% when I train, but I am extremely committed to making progress. And that's what keeps me going, it's what makes me stronger, etc. Just keep reminding yourself about how far you've come and how much you've already achieved. And we're done. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and smash that subscribe button if you want to see more awesome content. Remember to download the English Goals sheet that I created especially for you to help you on your journey to improve your English. Hope to see you guys soon, and until next time, bye.